make me wanna leave this place. Still I keep coming back for more of the same. Defend the dying flame. Here inside these walls that seem to move a little closer every day. There must be a way out of this crazy game we play out to the end. Let us just pretend a while, think about the good things now and then. We will see the day when you or I will stay your face up to the end. Let us just pretend a while, think about the good things now and then.
Hey everyone, and welcome to the channel. I've got another guitar lesson tutorial video for you, and it's going to be how to play Now and Then by Gordon Lightfoot. This song is from the Cold on the Shoulder album from 1975. It's one of my favorite Gordon Lightfoot albums. It's a lot of great songs on it, and as well as this one. This video comes as a request from Shadow. And so just want to give you a quick shout out. Thank you for requesting this video. And for the rest of you out there, if you see my other covers of Gordon's material or any other songs and you want a lesson video on them, be sure to leave me a comment below and I will definitely look into doing that. So let's go ahead and get right into the song. This song is in standard tuning, capo on the second fret. This is not particularly a hard song, but there's a lot of chord changes in it, so you want to watch out for that. It's a lot to do, but the good thing is about the chord changes and the progression is once you get it down through the first verse or two, the rest of the song repeats, and so it's fairly easy once you get that down. So we're going to be in the key of C. If you were going to play this without a capo, it would be D, but since we're transposed up on the second fret, it's going to be in the key of C, so that's how we're going to refer it to. So the chords used in this song are as follows. So you have a C major, an F major, an E minor, A minor, D over F sharp, D minor 7, and you have a G, as well as a C major 7 too. And those are all the chords used in the song. Let's go ahead and break down the intro. It's a pretty simple intro, but there's a couple little things you can do with it. I've seen some charts of this song, and it shows no intro. It just shows straight into E minor, which is wrong, because actually the song, if you listen to the record, starts out on C. Then I've seen some other charts, too, that show the chords progression in the intro as C, E minor, F. And you can do that, but it doesn't sound quite right. If you want to play it like Gordon Lightfoot did, I'll show you that right here. So here's the intro, full speed, and I'll slow it down. So this intro is basically a back and forth between C major and F major with some hammer-ons and pull-offs. And I've seen a video of Gordon Lightfoot in the last couple of years. I think it might have been 2018 or maybe 21 of him doing this song toward at the end of his touring career. And there's a close-up of his hands. And I saw on what he was doing, and he was doing the hammer-on between the two C and F, and that's the only chords that he plays in the intro. And funny thing about this intro was, I just discovered this recently before I did a cover of this song last month, was that there's a Don Henley song that came out in the 80s called The Heart of the Matter, and the intro to that song starts at exactly the same as Now and Then, and I have to wonder if Don Henley may have been inspired by this song when he wrote that. But anyhow, so here's the intro slowed down, and I'll show you what I'm doing with hammer-ons. What you're doing there is you're doing a hammer-on and pull-off on C and F. So here's C. So you do your basic C shape. Now what I'm playing here is more of a C, G. That's just a preference. It doesn't make a difference when you're singing the song. It's just a personal preference. I like the sound of it. You can play the song regular C without hitting that bass note, but to me it just sounds fuller and richer if you do it this way. If you want to do it this way, you just take, you know, your standard ring finger on the B string, your middle finger on the G string, your pinky finger is going to be on the A string, and your ring finger is going to be on the C, on the E, sorry, low E's. But anyway, so here's the intro of the C. Here's what you're doing. You're doing a hammer-on, and I'll show you. So what you're going to do is hammer-on and lift off your middle finger, and I'll show you, on the D string. So here we go, slow down. Again. And then after you do that, you're going to go to the F, and I'll show that. So you're doing the same hammer-on on the F, but so here's the F part. So you're going to basically, on the F chord, you're going to hammer, you're going to hammer on and pull off the B string and the G string. So, and then you go back to the C. So again, slow. Practice that back and forth. After you do that, so it's done. So the C and F is done two times. So here's the first time. Second time. To the E minor now. And you go right into the verse. So after you go into the verse, after you got that intro, you go right into the verse. I think this time you said enough to make me wanna leave this place. Still I keep coming back for more of the same, to fan the dying flame. There's a lot of chords in that verse. So here's the chords in that part. So after you've done the intro and you go on the E minor, I think this, then you go to the F, time. Now real quick, you can play F major like this, or you can play it like this. I've seen Gordon Lightfoot do this a lot. This is almost like an F major 7, sorta. It's kind of like that. He does it a lot in a lot of his songs. I've never seen him bar like that. But that's, again, a personal preference. It's just how I like to do it. You can usually you do what best suits the song, what best suits you. But for the intro, I forgot to mention this, you're going to want to use this shape. So basically you're making a C shape, keeping your pinky finger where you are the whole time, and moving your three other fingers back. So you're going to have, for that F, you're going to have ring finger on the A string, your pinky finger on the D, and your middle finger is going to be on the G. And of course your B string will not be, you're good on that. So there it is again. So one more time, because I think I messed it up. It's gonna be B string, G string, D string, and A string. And then you're gonna take your thumb and bar the low E string on the first fret up here. It's a little bit of a stretch, but you can do that. So now back into the verses, I apologize. So it's gonna still be on, and here's the chords for that. E minor, I think this time, F, C, you've said enough, F, to make me want, E minor, to leave this place. Sorry, A minor, place. D D over F sharp.
Still I keep F coming back.
E minor for more, A minor of the same. Then this is D minor 7.
To fan the dying flame.
Now, so here's what you can do with that. So again, E minor is not hard. F's pretty easy. C, F,
to make me wanna leave this place.
And when he says to leave this place, there's a hammer. I don't know if Gordon Lightfoot is doing a hammer-on, but I do hear Terry Clements doing something of that on his lead guitar. So I've incorporated in that, because a lot of the times I'm playing Gordon Lightfoot songs, I'm playing by myself. So if I can add a little extra flavor to the guitar chords while playing alone, from like a line from Terry, if it's doable, I'll take it. And so I do a little hammer on with the A, to leave this place, and then it goes. So you're gonna do a hammer on or pull off with your, on the A minor chord with the, on the G string and the B string, and it's a hammer on and pull off. And then after you do that, sorry. So after you've done that, then you go right to the D over F sharp.
To make me wanna leave this place.
You go to a D over F sharp.
Still I keep
F
coming back.
E minor
for more of the same.
A minor into a D minor 7
to fan the dying flame.
Real quick, for those of you who are not familiar with D minor 7, you're going to take your index finger and middle finger and put it on the, so middle finger is going to be on the high E first fret, your pinky's going to be on the B strings first fret, and then your ring finger is going to go to the G string second fret, and that's how you make a D minor 7. And then when it goes to dying flame, I can almost hear a G sus, a G sus chord in there. Again, that's also down to preference. It's not written in the charts, but it's just something you can do. So let's go ahead and do that first verse broke slow, and I'll do it again. So here's the intro, then the verse.
I think this time you've said enough to make me wanna leave this place. Still I keep coming back for more of the same, to fan the dying flame.
And that's it for the first part of the verse. And then when you go back to here inside these walls, you're going back to C. So here inside these walls, C major 7,
that seemed to move.
A minor,
a little closer, C, every day, F.
And then change to D over F sharp. And then to C.
There must be a way out of this G crazy game we play out to the end.
A minor, F, hammer on.
Let us just pretend a while, see. G, think about the good things now and then.
A minor, then go to F. Back to the intro. So here's that part slowed down again.
Here inside these walls that seem to move a little closer every day, there must be a way out of this crazy game we play out to the end. Oh no, let us just pretend a while, think about the good things now and then.
Back to intro now. And into the next verse. And And that is, once you've got these chords down, that's the progression repeats, and that's the whole song. One more thing I want to show you is right after, here he goes to, let's see. Take away the in-between. Think about the good things now and then. We will see the day when you or I will stay our face up to the end. Let us just pretend a while. Think about the good things now and then. You notice a change there. So after he says, take away the in-between, think about the good things now and then, there's sort of a string swells that come up to transition into the final verse, or a tag, I guess you could say. So think about the good things now and then. I'm going to go to the F, F, D over F sharp, then. We will see the day, see you and I, G, you stay your face up to the A minor. Then the F, let us just pretend a while, C, G, think about the good things now and then. Instead of playing A minor like you did before, the song's going to end on an A major. And that's how it's going to end. So listen to the song, play closely, and you got that. This song is pretty simple. One last thing I should have mentioned earlier is the strumming pattern. It's pretty simple from the intro, so it's like ba 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 da da ba 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 ba. So once you got that down, it's gonna be, this song is, it's gonna be easy. You just gotta remember all the chords and all the chord placements. I'll try to include a link to the Wayne Francis Lightfoot Internet Companion site that has the chords down there so you can follow along. And so that's the song. I hope it was helpful to you guys. If you like this video, please be sure to leave a comment, like, and subscribe. And again, if you want to see more tutorial videos, just leave a comment below, and I'll look into that. I should be getting back to posting some more songs here soon on the channel, so with a lot of Gordon Lightfoot and a few other artists in between, so keep an eye out for that. And I'll see you guys next time.